Morning, everyone. Welcome to our service this morning. And last week I was asked, is it possible that the words could be on the broadcast that we live stream? So I'm trying to hear it so that hopefully whoever is watching can see the words on the screen. They can certainly hear the congregation singing, so keep that up. That's good. One of the comments made recently was that one of the hymns that we sang, certain people didn't know it. And so that was good too, because we introduced some folk to a new song. And I'll give some announcements after we sing the first hymn, Wonderful Words of Life.
Food Bank, Food to September.
Please feel free to call people who aren't able to join us. That's also an encouragement for me. Also, the messages are online if you want to listen. If you've missed any, please feel free to, if you have that access, to do that. All the other information is on the back. There are a couple of matters for prayer, and I'll bring those up a little bit later on and update you on our situation as we now are actually living in Osage Beach, although we still have to, some work to do. I think those are all the announcements I need to share with you. Let's pause for a prayer. Let's pray. Lord, as we come to worship you this morning, we thank you that we're able to. We ask, Lord, that you will watch over us and that you'll keep us safe. We pray for our nation. We pray for people to recognize the need of you. And so, Lord, we pray that this morning as we share together, as we sing, as we share together in prayer, as we hear your word, Lord, we pray for your blessing. May we continue to appreciate the freedoms that we enjoy. And we just ask that you will bless us as we worship you this morning. May our worship be acceptable to you as we worship you in spirit and in truth. We ask all these things and bring our praise to you in Jesus' name. Amen. Now another well-known hymn. Again, it's a very popular remembering from, again, may learn at Sunday school, Jesus Loves Me.
Thank you.
as we come to a time of prayer, there are those from our fellowship who need our prayers especially. Carol's husband, Bob, has been admitted to hospital. He's been transferred to Barry, and he is having some problems, so both need our prayers. Also, I'm sure on the prayer line, has gone out to Joyce Maxwell's son, who has been here with the family, had some bad news last week, and he's in need of surgery, urgent surgery. And so, remember the family in your prayers. I said I would update you about our situation. We moved into our new home in Pacific Beach. We still have to clear the property in Barry, and we're working on that. And this morning, Sandy's working on getting somebody to offload a truck that is in our driveway. We really feel blessed to be able to be in the area and know that it's where God wants us to be. So we appreciate your continued prayers and support as we continue through this. Quite a strenuous thing to move, and we're finding it challenging, put it that way. I'm so looking forward to the future. We need to be at this moment in time praying. Praying because I believe there are many things that we need to be aware of, but also many things that we ourselves can be doing in ways of supporting each other and encouraging each other. The rules that are being given to us are there for, according to the health department, and we do what we can to follow them. In these days, we need more than ever to remember what our vision is, to live by faith, to be known by our love, to be a voice of hope. It seems to me that there are so many situations, so many places where an alternative viewpoint is not accepted. Instead, it becomes hatred. And there seems to be a growing hatred towards the Christian faith, towards what Scripture teaches us about the way that we need to live. And we do need to pray that we ourselves will have an opportunity to be strong. Even if people come against us and they get angry towards us, let us instead just show love and compassion. Let us be more like Jesus. We have the strongest criticism for those who were religious leaders of his day. So as much as we can pray about, I invite you to bring your own personal prayers, and then I will lead you in prayer. Let's pray. Almighty God, our loving Heavenly Father, we thank you that we can come to you, and you know all about us. You know those things that weigh heavy upon us. And Lord, we come to you. We want to bring all our worries, all our anxieties to you. Help us to leave them with you. And sometimes, forgive us, we carry them away after already bringing them to you. But Lord, we thank you that you are a God who loves us, who sent his Son into the world to save us, who sent his Holy Spirit to be with us, to bring us comfort and strength day by day. And so we thank you, O God, that you are in control of all things, even though sometimes we wonder, but Lord, we know that you are the Almighty, the King of creation, the Lord of the universe, and you are our Heavenly Father. As we come, Lord, we bring each other to you. Every member of this fellowship, Lord, you know each and every situation. And we just commit each one to you. We pray especially at this time for Carol and for Bob, for Joyce Maxwell and the family who are struggling at this time with the news that they recently had. We pray that all things will go well and that surgery will be successful and that, Lord, they might experience your healing touch. For those who are unable to join us, we commit them to you and ask your blessing upon them. Lord, we thank you for the opportunity that we have to share by means of the internet these messages. We ask, Lord, that you bless each one. Many who are frightened because of this virus, Lord, we pray that you will bring comfort and healing to each and every situation. For our nation that seems to be going its own way and forgetting about you, Lord, help us as your people to pray for our nation, to pray that people will come back into a realization of their need of you. So help us day by day to live for you and to demonstrate your love to each person we meet. So again, we thank you for all your blessings. We are so blessed to be living where we are. We pray for those who are facing very real persecution because of their faith. Lord, draw near and give us strength, we pray. And help us to appreciate the freedoms that we enjoy. So again, we commit ourselves at this time to you and ask that you bless us. We pray all these things in the name of Jesus, who taught us right to pray the same. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, the power, and the glory, forever and ever. Amen. I have to confess that this week has been a challenging week in lots of ways, and I normally am able to give the information for the to put on the screen and to put in the bulletin beforehand, but not so this week. I want to read from Psalm 31, and it's what God has put on my heart to share today. It'll be the basis for which we take the message today. I love the Psalms because I know many times I've shared this with you that the Psalms are so much an important part of church worship down through the years and amongst the nation of Israel for many years too. And we don't have the music, we have the words. And the words are certainly more important than the music. For the message this morning, I was trying to get some music to play on the screen, and I didn't manage to do it, so instead I have the words. So we don't have the music, but I have the words. So Psalm 31, in you, Lord, I have taken refuge. Let me never be put to shame. Deliver me in your righteousness. Turn your ear to me, come quickly to my rescue. Be my rock of refuge, a strong fortress to save me. Since you are my rock and my fortress, for the sake of your name, lead and guide me. Keep me safe, keep me free from the trap that is set for me. For you are my refuge. Into your hands I commit my spirit. Deliver me, Lord, my faithful God. I hate those who cling to worthless idols. As for me, I trust in the Lord. I will be glad and rejoice in your love, for you saw my affliction and knew the anguish of my soul. You have not given me into the hands of the enemy, but you set my feet in a spacious place. Be merciful to me, Lord, for I am in distress. My eyes grow weak with sorrow, my soul and body with grief. My life is consumed by anguish, and my years by groaning. My strength fails because of my affliction, my bones grow weak. Because of all my enemies, I am yet a contempt of my neighbors, and an object of dread to my closest friends, those who see me on the street flee from me. I am forgotten as though I were dead. I become like broken pottery, for I hear many whispering terror on every side. They conspire against me and plot to take my life. But I trust in you, Lord. I say, you are my God. My times are in your hands. Deliver me from the hands of my enemies, from those who pursue me. Let your face shine on your servant. Save me in your unfailing love. Let me not be put to shame, Lord, for I have cried out to you. But let the wicked be put to shame and be silent in the realm of the dead. Let their lying lips be silenced, for with pride and contempt they speak arrogantly against the righteous. How abundant are the good things that you've stored up for those who flee, that you bestow in the sight of the poor, on those who take refuge in you. In the shelter of your presence you hide them from all human intrigues. You keep them safe in your dwelling from accusing tongues. Praise be to the Lord, for he showed me the wonders of his love when I was in a city under siege. In my alarm I said, I'm cut off from your sight. Yet you heard my cry for mercy when I called to you for help. Love the Lord, all his people who hope in the Lord. God bless that reading of his word. Praise the Lord Jesus.
Thank you.
because of the late bigness of the message, I thought, well, what is it? Time. Time. What is time? We are governed by time so often. And sometimes we say we don't have enough time. And time is something that we live with day by day. There's a time, Ecclesiastes says, there's a time for everything. There is a time. And I wondered, what is it that I could share that would help us in these days, in these times, as we think about time, as we wait for things to, if they ever are going to open up completely again in the way that we once knew. As we think about time, it's surprising that we need to understand something that God is eternal. And there is time and there is eternity. Time is what we understand because there's a time to be born and there's a time to die. And in between that is life. So we have time. How do we use our time? You know, I thought of a song this morning. One of the things that came to me, if I could save time in a bottle, the first thing I'd like to do is to save every day till eternity passes away, just to spend them with you. You can't put time in a bottle. Time goes on. If I could make days last forever, if words could make wishes come true, I'd save every day like a treasure, and then again, I would spend them with you. You know, this song is a kind of a love song, but it's a song that we can think of that we really want to spend time with God, that we really want to appreciate His love for us. That we wish that we could put things confined, and we can't do that. It goes on. But there never seems to be enough time to do the things you want to do once you find them. I've looked around enough to know that you're the one I want to go through time with. If I had a box just for wishes and dreams that had never come true, the box would be empty, except for the memory of how they were answered by you. But there never seems to be enough time to do the things you want to do once you find them. I've looked around enough to know that you're the one I want to go through time with. Time. How important is time to us? The writer of the Hebrews talks about time, and he says this in Hebrews chapter 2. He says, we must pay the most careful attention, therefore, to what we've heard, so that we do not drift away. For since the message spoken to angels was binding, and every violation and disobedience received its just punishment, how shall we escape if we ignore so great a salvation? This salvation, which was first announced by the Lord, was confirmed to us by those who heard it. God also testified to it by signs, wonders, and various miracles, and by gifts of the Holy Spirit, distributed according to His will. The time. God's timing is perfect. In Galatians we read this, when the fullness of time came, God sent His Son. in chapter 4, he says this: when the set time had fully come, God sent his son, born of a woman, born under the law, to redeem those under the law, that we might receive adoption to sonship. Time. God is in control of time. And yet he is eternal. He is outside of time. Jesus Christ is the same yesterday, today, and forever. Time is what we have. Time is what we, what do we do with our time? How do we use our time? One thing is clear, that we need to recognize the importance of the moment that we have. We need to recognize that God has given us this moment. We can't change anything about the past. We can choose today how we will respond for the future. We can't reach into the future. We can only live for this moment in time. Now is the acceptance of our boy. And it was a Welsh translation says, yesterday never returns. In other words, we were taught that we need to make sure that we don't waste our time, because what yesterday is not coming back. Make the most of today, because there's nothing we can do about yesterday. In these days, we are finding things difficult. Many people have been confined for a long time, and I feel heavy for those people who have not even been able to have visitors because of this pandemic. And I felt that the psalmist comes to this place where he comes to this understanding about time. My times are in your hands. Here he is in the center of this psalm, recognizing that my times are in your hands. We need to understand that too, that our times are in God's hands. Yes, we need to know how we will respond day by day. And the psalmist gives us a very real picture of how we can use the time, how we can spend the time to really make a difference. Because we need to make a difference in our own lives before we can make a difference in anybody else's lives. Because we ourselves need to be walking the way that God wants us to walk. We need to be remembering that God hears us. God answers our prayers. I don't know how many times I am so thankful that I have God as my Heavenly Father. The Holy Spirit is my comforter, and Jesus is my Savior. I can say it in practical ways. God answers prayers, sometimes miraculously, and sometimes in other ways. You know, in the move that we are making, we moved our furniture, or at least we had a company to move our furniture from Barrie to Masika Beach. And Sandy arrived here first and got the house ready to receive the furniture, so she knew where she wanted everything put. And as I pulled in after locking up in Barrie and making my way, I pulled in just after the truck was pulling in. And they just wanted directions to put the stuff that they had put on last, which came off first, which was just the yard equipment. And so I left the car, and I could see that Sandy was in a bit of a panic situation, and so I left the car on the dirt and went to put the stuff. After they had gone, I went looking for my car keys and I couldn't find them. I didn't know what to do. I knew that they must be somewhere, but where? They'd offloaded everything, they had put everything. In the end, they just dumped so much stuff in our garage. Anyway, I didn't have the keys. And thankfully, Sandy had another set of keys, so we were okay. But I have to confess, I started to get anxious. I started to get worried. She said, "Don't worry, just trust." Easy said than done, but days went by and I prayed specifically about, please help me to find the keys. And there was something else that I needed God's help with. And we both needed God's help with them. And I just committed to Him. And I took one last walk around the yard that I'd gone and looked in all the places that I thought I could have dropped them. And suddenly I shouted, "Hallelujah, praise the Lord." And my keys were there. This was days after that they were found. And it was on that particular day that I had said, "Lord, I need those keys, please help me find them. Show me where they are." He did. And that's the way that he helps us through in practical ways. I was so thankful because I didn't know. I started to think that maybe I needed to report my keys missing. But Sandy keeps saying, trust. God knows. God knows. And so true. We need to come to that place where we are comfortable. We know that there are things that cause us very real anxiety. And we need to know that God is available to us. He is always there for us. He is always here for us. And as followers of Jesus, as those who have been born again of His Spirit, He is with us. Sometimes we feel things are getting tough. People are coming against us. Just as David described the way that he felt as he looked at his situation and the way people were coming against him. He began by making that statement, "In You, Lord, I have taken refuge." And that's where we need to be. Lord, in You we take refuge. Things around us and the things that are taking place in this world really are for time. But God is with us in time for eternity. And He says, "Since You are my rock and my fortress, for the sake of Your name, lead me and guide me." So we can ask Him to help us. "Keep me from the trap that is set for me, for You are my refuge." We need to be careful because sometimes traps are set for us as followers of Jesus today. He says, "Into Your hands I commit my spirit." Remember, those are the words that Jesus used as He surrendered His life for us. "Into Your hands I commit my spirit." As He fulfilled God's plan, as His time had come, He cried, "Finish. Into Your hands I commit my spirit." Using these words of David, who had committed his life to God, but time, that God will take us through to eternity. He talks about those around, and "I hate those who cling to worthless idols. As for me, I trust in the Lord." Be merciful to me. My life is consumed by anguish. All these experiences that we can have, my life is consumed by anguish, my years by groanings, my strength fails because of my affliction, and my bones grow weak because of all my enemies and their contempt of my neighbors. Describe really these physical feelings of anxiety and the feeling of weakness. of anguish. And you know, God has given us the strength to go through some of those. Our bodies are not as young as they were, and it takes its toll on us. My bones grow weak, but God is with us. He says, I'm forgotten as though I were dead. I've become like broken pottery, for I hear many whisperings, terror on every side. They conspire against me and plot to take my life. But I trust in you, Lord. I say, you are my God. My times are in your hands. Deliver me from the hands of my enemies, from those who pursue me. We need to experience that. We need to, as the days are marching on, realize that there are people who will be coming against us as believers. Because they don't want to recognize that God is a holy God. And that sin is something that is very real, that inflicts the human race. And that Jesus is the one who came into the world to save us, to take our sins away. And he came that we might have life eternal. That life begins now, and that body life sometimes means hardship. But know that God is with us through those difficult times. And nobody can take our life from us until it is, God says, it's our time. My times are in your hands. We need to come to understand that. That God knows the end from the beginning. God knows how many days we have. That God wants us to have that experience of Him. That we can live each day and be thankful for each day that we have. And to know that even though we may go through a difficult time, we can know His strength as we go through. One of the prayers that the Apostle Paul asked was that the church would pray that he might make the best use of his time. And I think that's a good prayer for us. I use that as a prayer for myself, that I might make the best use of my time. We can waste our time on all kinds of things because we think we have time. The psalmist, as he looks at his own situation, he begins by looking at God and then expresses his own anguish and his own, but he comes back and says, how abundant are the good things that you've stored up for those who fear you, that you bestow in the sight of all on those who take refuge in you. In the shelter of your presence you hide them from all human intrigues. You keep them safe in your dwelling from accusing time. Praise be the Lord, for he showed me the wonders of his love when I was innocent and innocent. God reveals himself to us. He has good things in store for us. The future is bright. There is so much alarmism. There has been a statement that this world is going to end in 10 days and that the there are so 10 years, I mean. There are so many people who are trying to express fear because all they think about is this life. But as believers in Jesus, we know that we have life, but we have eternal life. We know time is only fleeting. James says, what is your life? It's even like a vapor that appears for a little while and then vanishes. Make the best use of time. Don't spend the time wallowing in mire. Instead, let God lift you up and put your feet in a strong place. The song that I was going to play you is a country song by Dean Brody. And there's a video of some young people talking about, there's plenty of time. A gang of kids on their pedal bikes in a dusty town. Wait to ride to the general store for Popeye cigarettes, class of 99. Here we lived, laughed, loved and cried. Took for granted that those days would never end. Living like that yearbook picture wouldn't fade. And some standing right beside me I might never see again. The trouble is, you think we have time. You think tomorrow's always coming down the line, and then one day you wake up and you find the trouble is you thought you had time. Student hired a fancy job, big old house, 2-car garage. He works hard for his wife and his son. An empty seat at T-ball games, just a sacrifice he'll make. Make it up next weekend comes along, years go by and that day comes too soon. That boy goes off to college. He stands in his empty room, and the trouble is, you think you have time. You think tomorrow's always coming down the line, and then one day you wake up and you find the trouble is you thought you had time. Shotgun shells and tackle box on the floorboard of a truck. Morning sun burning fog off a lake, a teenage girl and a granddad. He takes her fishing, but he feels bad. She can't take her eyes off that Facebook page. But someday soon, who knows how long, she'll look up from that phone and he'll be gone. The trouble is, you think you have time. You think tomorrow's always coming down the line, and then one day you wake up and you find the trouble is you thought you had time. The trouble is you thought you had time. That line, she can't take her eyes off that Facebook page. But someday soon, who knows how long, she'll look up from that phone and he'll be gone. Appreciate the time you have with loved ones. Appreciate the time that God has given you for these moments. It's so difficult that we can't meet as families at this moment in time. We are unable to see our grandkids and the same thing. It's difficult. Time. We need to recognize the time that we have and use it in the best way that we can. Don't let circumstances pull you down. Instead, look out to the one who has our best interests at heart. The world around will not. The world around will try and pull us down. The world around will try and get us into its mold. But God wants us to understand that He is holy. That He is the one who controls time. Jesus is coming again. That time is getting close. Another day we'll look at some of the signs of the times that we can see that are being fulfilled. And make me keep looking at. Not get caught up in what is around, although we need to be aware and pray. Be aware and pray. Because it seems that we are living in a day and age when government wants to take control of all things. And our freedom will be gone. We need to pray that we might be able to retain the freedoms that we have enjoyed. There is certainly at work in this world organizations who are trying to disrupt the family. The family has already been disrupted because of the lives that we live. Because close families that once were are no longer. It's a sad situation. But they are intent on destroying family life and replacing it with something else that is government controlled. Watch and pray. Praise to the Lord, says the psalmist, for he showed me the wonders of his love when I was innocent yet deceived. In my alarm I said, I'm cut off from your sight. Yet you heard my cry for mercy when I called you to you for help. Love the Lord, all his people. The Lord preserves those who are true to him. And he closes it, be strong and take heart, all you who hope in the Lord. Be strong and take heart, all you who hope in the Lord. Take the time, spend time with those you can. We can't put time in a bottle. We know that we have limited time, but the time that we have can be different if we take a different attitude. If we don't allow things to crowd in on us and cause us to be weighed down with anxiety and cause us to be depressed. Instead, know that there is one that we can turn to who will lift us up. Others may want to pull us down and drag us down. Be strong and take heart. Paul in his letter to the Ephesians says, be strong in the Lord and in his mighty power. Put on the whole armor of God that you might be able to withstand the wiles of the devil. Time. We can make time for God. We can give our lives to him, give our time to him. Allow him to lead us. The psalmist says, since you are my rock and my fortress, for the sake of your name, lead and guide me. That should be our prayer in these days of COVID, and days of government control. We need to ask that God will lead and guide us, and that we might find the strength that we need from him day by day, knowing that we have a future. This life is not all that there is. And it's a taste of the future. Heaven came down and glory filled my soul desire. Let me sing that. Thank you. my soul. Help us to recognize that day by day, that we might live for you, that we might make the best use of our time, that we might not allow ourselves to be brought down by circumstances, instead to bring ourselves to you so that you can lift us up. So bless us as we go from here. Thank you for enabling us to come together to worship. We pray now that each of us might know and experience the blessing of Almighty God, Father, Son, and Holy Spirit, now and always.